have the best energy. I love you. And today's show is all about finding what works. Dynamics are interesting. Life is not one size fits all. And what might work for someone else may not be what's right for you. So to get to your place of yes, you have to be honest about your needs and communicate to others what you want. Well, my first guests hit a groove working together as co-hosts of NBC's Today. Check them out in action. Wow. Welcome to the show, Natalie Morales and Willie Geist. Do they not look like a couple that comes to a cocktail? You look like a married couple that comes to a cocktail party.
And we show up everywhere with drinks in our hands.
Yes.
Because why wouldn't
we? We like this. We'd like to put this on the set of the Today Show every day.
Well, that's what Hoda and Kathy do.
There are two other people who stole that act.
Yeah.
That's kind of their territory.
Yeah, that show is a cocktail party.
By the way, this energy in this room is crazy.
Isn't it fun?
We need this.
Both of you have been in long marriage. You're with your... Not high school sweetheart, grammar school sweetheart.
I met my wife when we were 11 years old. Sixth grade. Aww.
It's the real deal.
Do you remember her as she was in sixth grade?
I do. I have a vision of her. We met in Mr. Kaplan's sixth grade homeroom class at George Washington Middle School in Ridgewood, New Jersey. And we had to get up because it was the first day of the new school, and you had to get up and stand in the corner based on what elementary school you went to. And she went to Willard, and they went and stood in this corner and said, "My gosh, who is that?"
Really?
And I vaguely remember what she was wearing, all these weird things. We didn't date till much later in life, and then we broke up a few times and all the rest of it. But I do remember the first time I saw her.
Tell her how you proposed.
Oh, so then I took her back to that same middle school and proposed to her in that classroom.
Really?
I did.
I love that story.
Am I laying it on too thick?
That's sweet. Come on.
And you have a pretty kind of normal life. I mean, you're entertainment industry, but you really separate. Yeah. Both of you do, right?
Yeah, I think it's important. You
have two kids, right?
I have two boys, 10 and 5. And
so you're in it.
I'm in it, but yeah, I mean, I started on the show pregnant with my first, and so I feel like you really need to kind of keep your private life private, as hard as that can be sometimes.
Have you been good at it?
I think for the most part, yeah. I mean,
I've been really great at it.
Yeah, I think your kids, you have to, right? Yeah, you learn unfortunately the hard way sometimes.
It helps too. Your family keeps you humble. I mean, I have two kids, 1 6, 1 4, who have no interest whatsoever in what I do for a living. They're like, the TV comes on in the morning, and my mom, they're getting ready for school. And my wife says, "Daddy's on." And they're like, "No, Bubble Guppies, get this off."
Oh yeah, SpongeBob, SpongeBob in my house.
And in fact, if someone's nice enough in a restaurant or something comes up and says hello, they mock me openly. These are 4-year-old children.
Really?
Like, "Ooh, Willie Geist, it's so nice to meet you." And I'm like,
"Really?
Why are you so mean to me?"
Really?
Yes.
Now you. You've recently taken up ice skating, I understand, with Tara Lipinski, of all people. Yeah.
This is me and Tara Lipinski not long ago on the Today Show. This is a gold medalist having to put up with me. She won a gold medal when she was 15, and now it's like, I'm doing the choppy with the rental skate.
I was gonna say, you look pretty good.
See, well, she's dragging me. That's what's really happening.
I especially love the move where you saved yourself from falling, which was
that was a key
move. And this, the one, the under the legs move, you actually forgot she was coming through.
I stood there with my legs open, and she came in, and I dragged her through from the back, and there she was. It's like I'd given birth to Tara Lipinski. It's amazing.
Who's the singer? You're the singer.
Oh, gosh, no.
Why is it that you love karaoke and you love singing?
Well, I mean, don't you love karaoke? No?
I like singing a cappella.
Oh.
Right.
Because I get anxiety from having to follow the karaoke. Yes.
I have to say I'm not good at it.
That's right.
And I know that. I know that.
Do
you
know,
don't need to tell me that.
Because you keep singing.
Do you commit?
But that's the key, is you have to, and I learned this from the great Liza Minnelli. There was a little hazing incident on our show this year where they brought Liza on to see if they could, maybe stage an intervention.
And
sort of a lesson.
Was it a lesson?
Yeah.
It was a very bad lesson.
What were the tips?
Well, at one point, Liza was actually, okay, that's enough, Natalie.
Yeah.
she cut me off. She was so patient,
then she just shut her down.
She's like, yeah.
She watched patiently.
Her tips were, you really have to be, I mean, it's not so much about being able to carry a tune, because most of us are probably tone deaf. But really,
most people are tone deaf. A lot of us are.
All right. A lot of us are. But it really is about, you know, it's the performance and believing in yourself and believing in that song.
Committing.
And committing to it and giving it out there.
Watch out.
You know, really working yourself up.
I like that. I love that you don't take yourself seriously. I just love that.
That's what we're about.
I know. You're like, and like my friend Hoda over at the Today Show with you.
Yeah. Grace is boring, right?
Seriously, I love Hoda.
You know what the great thing about Natalie is? She can do really hard news, and we've been in these positions before, and turn on a dime. Because at the end of our sort of wacky, chatty segment, we used to do the news immediately following. I remember it was a Bon Jovi song.
Oh, yeah.
She went down, she's like, I'm going to get my 80s jersey hair. Puts her hair down, does that. Comes up, her hair's like
this whole look.
Starts singing Living on a Prayer. That ends. And then she turns to
the
her news scripts and
you
says...
You gotta think the big buffon.
She's got the big hair. Then she turns and goes...
Live from Afghanistan.
War on the Korean Peninsula. Seriously, you guys, take me seriously. There's gonna be a war in Korea.
Well, I love that, but that's...
She pulls it off.
I love that about everybody. I know all you at the Today Show. You're the first show that I was ever on. When I first did a cooking segment years ago, you've always been so good to me. And what I love about everyone over there is you all are obviously such professional journalists, but you all don't take yourself seriously, and you like to have fun, and I really do love that. I think that's why it's such a great show.
Thank you.
I really do.
Thank
yes.
Thank you.
Speaking of having fun, when we come back, Natalie and Willie break the news every day, but do you think they actually remember once they go off the air? We are putting them to the test.
Uh-oh.
Up next.
Oh, boy.
And Willie Geist from the Today Show. On Today, they tell us all the news of the day, and now that it's 2014, just what do they remember about 2013? Welcome to Yesterday, Not Today. I'm your host, Bethenny Frankel.
Yes.
Are you ready to play?
Ready.
Buzzer in hand.
Very well. I'm going to give the wheel a spin, and you'll have to answer a question from the category it lands on. Audience, if Natalie and Willie get 4 answers correct, you're going home with a prize. This is what you will be playing for.
Wow.
I understand you have new digs over there at the Today Show, so please make room for the sparkle pink Bethenny trophy.
Wow.
It's a bedazzle.
Now, each of you has a buzzer. Ring when you know the answer.
Okay.
Are we ready to spin the wheel?
We are ready.
Yes.
For the first win, people.
The first category is scandal.
Okay. In 2013, Rob Ford was mayor of what city when he was caught in a scandal?
Toronto.
Correct. The answer is the next category is world sports.
Events.
Not to be confused with world sports. In 2013, what date was Prince George born?
You have to know.
Are there two choices?
Yes.
A, May 5th, 2013. B, July 22nd.
July 22nd. Whoa. Slow down there. July 20, the other number you were about to say.
July 22nd. July 22nd.
July 22nd.
That is correct.
Yes.
I was there the whole time.
Natalie was there, too.
The whole time.
Now the Today Show tie, people.
Yes.
I will spin the wheel for the next category.
Okay.
The next category is sports. In 2013, who led Major League Baseball in home runs?
Home runs. Oh, I got this.
Come on.
Orioles.
Where's your buzzer?
Oh. Chris Davis. Who is Chris Davis?
Okay.
Yeah.
Nice.
Thank you.
Good job.
Okay.
Oh. Another scandal.
Oh, boy.
Wow.
We have another scandal, people. Oh, we can't.
Oh. Spin again. There it is.
Yes.
In 2013, what was the number one movie over the 4th of July weekend? The choices are A, Despicable Me 2, B, The Conjuring, C, Man of Steel, D, The Lone Ranger.
Not The Lone Ranger.
I'm going to go Despicable Me 2.
That is correct.
That's it. That's it.
I would like to present you with a score update. Willie Geist 3, Natalie Morales 1. We are not calling all my girls here today, people.
Don't worry.
Okay, the next topic. This will be the last question.
Oh, my goodness.
Celebrity news. In 2013, which actress filed legal documents to officially change her last name from Muniz back to her maiden name?
Wait.
The correct answer is not wait.
Muniz, you said?
Muniz?
Oh, I was thinking Mila Kunis. That's not right.
No.
She's dating someone 20 years her junior, who is a dancer.
Oh. 20 years her junior. Hey, audience.
J-Lo.
J-Lo. Thank you, the audience. The audience gets one.
Do they get the
free? The audience gets one. Natalie and Willie, you got 5 questions right. Willie got 3, Natalie got 2. That means everyone in the audience is going home with Nerium AD's age-defying treatment night cream.
All right.
Yes. And the trophy goes to Willie for getting the most questions correct.
All right. Let's see how tall, it's almost as tall as him.
Thank you both so much for being here. Tune into today's show every morning at 7 a.m. NBC. Coming up, when someone in your life does you wrong, is it worth it to get relationship revenge?
Yes.
We are going to find out next. Yes, you say yes,
yes.
You little minx.
Yes.
When we come back.